This video covers two sessions at Beach Road in Shoreham, one in June, one in July. This stretch is midway between the Burrells and the Church of Good Shepherd, i.e. at the start of the open beach past the Rock Armour groins. I'm here to catch place, but I'll change tactics if needs be. In the first session, I'm starting with 3-foot clipped down rigs, one with beads, one without. I've set up 3/4 of an hour or so before high tide, and I'll be fishing it down, and I'm expecting to be fishing at distance for most of the time. This beach is normally quite busy, with sunbathers, swimmers, paddleboarders, kayakers and dog walkers. All hazards you just got to get used to. As I'm awaiting my first bite, I'll run through the locational details. I've covered a regional setting in my previous Shoreham video, so here I'll go straight in to Shoreham and Lancing. The Shoreham stretch extends from Widewater to Kingston Beach in Shoreham Harbour. I've located Beach Road in relation to other local marks. The adjacent Ferry Road mark can get even busier, since it leads to the footbridge over the River Adour to the town centre. The Beach Road stretch is between Beach Green and Ferry Road. You park in the road itself, which runs close to the beach. Beach Road adjoins Old Fort Road, which takes you to the Burrows and the western arm of Harbour. I've pinpointed the two marks I fished for this video. It's a very slow start and I didn't get any bites on the way up or over high water, and now it's time to start moving down the beach. When I'm struggling to get a bite, I'll quite often change over one rig over to a boom rig. So that's what I've done in this case. For bait, I'm using both black lug and ragworm. Thank you. Just as I settle down after making my move, I get my first indication. A couple of little knocks and then one slightly better one is worth a strike. Nothing big, but it is the target species and it saves the blank, so the boom rig gets me out of trouble again. The place took the black lug on the bottom hook. As it's ebbing, I'm starting to pick up the odd bit of weed, but nothing compared to what it was like a few weeks back. You may have noticed I've also swapped my other rig over, so I'm now using two different rigs than what I started off with. When it's hard going, I find it's often worth swapping your rigs around. You never know, you might come across something which works. So I'm now using a short wire boom rig and a two hook loop rig. still only the one bite so far, and I feel like I'm just going through the motions. Just as I packed away one rod, a switch back to using free hook clip down rig with beads gets me my second and last bite of the day. Okay, so it's not a place, however it is a result, a decent sized flounder. So, a pretty disappointing session, with only two bites and two fish, but at least they're flatfish. A few weeks later, I was back to give this stretch another go. I started with this free hook clip down rig, and I've got a loop rig on my other rod. Bait is the same, black lug and ragworm. Last time, on the bottom snood of my loop rig, I had alternating black and green beads, 6mm in size. This time, I've started with smaller beads, 4mm, and they're red and yellow in colour. I find that the rigs tangle less when using smaller beads, but I'm not sure if the colour makes any difference at all. The flounder in the last session took top hook, and that was on the snood with black and green beads, but it's probably going after the ragworm rather than the lugworm on the other two hooks. A much better start this time, an early response on my free hook clip down rig. But it feels a bit strange, the fish is kiting, so it's not going to be a flatfish. Well, that's the result. A fairly decent sized golden grey mullet. It makes a welcome change. It's been a while since I've caught one of these. They're lovely looking fish and hard fighting too. Having returned the mullet, I notice a bite on my other rod. Two fish in quick succession makes up for the previous outing. This time it is a place, but not very big in size. And it's gone for the black lug on the snood with beads. A quick pan round the area, then a quick look at the two rigs I've started on for this session. I think I had a bite on a drop, and as soon as I tightened up to the lead, tip's gone round. And it's another golden grey, about the same size as the previous one. getting funny little knocks now, so I'm twitching the bait, see if I can get a better response. Those knocks don't develop, but occasionally, out of the blue, I get a big knock which I can't hit. I strike into a little knock, but I'm not sure if I've got anything on. The culprit's another place, much smaller in size, this time taking a small bit of ragman. Having had a couple of sharp knocks which I can't hit, I decided to switch over to a sheppy rig. I'm thinking that those knocks are from the mullet, and long snood sheppy rig might help hit those. Since I had a bite on the drop earlier, I've attached a floating bead on one of the snoods. I'll now be trying this rig at different distances, since quite often those golden grey mullet can be caught quite close in. Having said that, the two I've caught so far have been at range, but you never know if they're also close in unless you try that. It's more than likely though that the swimmers have probably put off a mullet from coming in close, but it's still worth a try. Quick sharp bite immediately after dragging the bait, but once again I miss it. I then get a series of little taps, which I do manage to hit, and the culprit's a small eel. get a sharp little knock on the sheppy rig, which I managed to hit. Not big, but I'm quite pleased with that. My first black bream of the summer. A few more bites that I couldn't hit, so I decided to stay until dusk. There's always a chance of a sole. I'll get my last bite of the day, and I managed to connect with that. Well, it's not a sole, but place number 3. A much better session than the previous one, and despite being frustrating with all those missed bites, I really enjoyed this. It's always nice to catch those golden grey mullet, and one of these days I'll figure out how to hit more of the bites.